Welcome to Baguio City. In our last episode, we had the pleasure of meeting some incredibly friendly Filipinos and exploring its bustling hotspots in the centre. Today, we're taking our adventure a step further, as we've decided to rent a scooter to uncover more of Baguio's top attractions, including its stunning natural beauty, tasty food, and a touch of tradition. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and let's jump straight into the video.
So we have managed, with great difficulty, to secure ourselves a trusty steed for the day. We've had to drive like 15 minutes outside the town. We've come to like the busiest car repair shop. There's honestly like hundreds of cars in here. We've swapped bikes 3 times for reasons I don't know. And now we've got a bike with a big box on the back that we can't open with the key. But we have a bike nonetheless, and we're excited to go and explore. So let's go to our first stop. So I've had a little bit of a nightmare start for the day. The roads in Baguio are actually really hard to drive around. So there's one road that there's no bicycles or motorcycles that are allowed down. And then we've kind of drove up to our destination and we've had to drive around for about 15 minutes for parking. But we found this spot by the yellow building, which is before 7-Eleven. So we're parked, we're here, we're safe, we've got fuel. Now we can enjoy the day.
So first stop of the day is Mind's Viewpoint, which is one of the most popular tourist destinations here in Baguio.
It's absolutely heaving as well, isn't it?
Yeah, well, that's why we couldn't find anywhere to park. And it feels like everyone drives here rather than motorcycles, so that's interesting.
We soon found out why most people didn't drive mopeds around the city.
So we have to pay a 10 pesos environmental fee each. I'm not sure if that's all we need to pay, but fairly reasonable.
Fairly reasonable, very reasonable.
How many, sir?
Two, please.
Two.
So we've walked in and it's tourist heaven. There are souvenir shops all over the place.
Smoothie places.
And it's all set on a hill, just little huts that are all down the slope. You see a woman selling corn in the background.
I reckon we could fit this one in my backpack.
Baguio is actually a lot cooler than the rest of the Philippines, and when we read about that before we arrived here, it was like hard to comprehend that it would be cooler because it's so hot and you just think, how can the Philippines be cool? But when we've arrived, it actually is like a summer's day in England, isn't it, Gaz?
I think the gauge is, am I dripping in sweat? Yes would be the answer everywhere else in the Philippines. There's not a bloody drip of sweat on me. My forehead's dry for once.
Exactly. So it's the climate is actually very unusual.
Which means it's around about 20 degrees.
Yeah, which is like a nice summer's day in the UK.
Anything over 20, I'm like, oh.
But I think that's why they've got plants and stuff that are all like around here, because I assume crops grow better in this kind of temperature than, you know, the heat of the Philippines.
It's more, what you meant to say, it's more optimal temperatures for growing nice flowers.
Exactly. So then now you come around and have a look at them and buy them, I guess. So that's cute. That's what we need. So you can rent traditional Filipino attire for 50 pesos per head, so I'm going to do it. Should we go? Do you want to do it?
Yeah, we've only actually got 50 pesos.
Is that it? Have we not got any more money today?
No.
You being serious?
No. You don't get a joke, do you?
Oh. Yes, please.
Okay, good.
Who do I pay?
Yeah, both of you?
Just me.
Oh, no, I will try. I'll try as well, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
It's 100 only, 50.
Okay,
50.
Yeah. Perfect, yeah.
So it's 100.
Yeah.
This is a nice experience.
Yeah,
yeah.
It is.
Right.
Okay.
Too big.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, give you 2 necklaces.
No.
All right, I'll find your hat.
Okay. Thank you.
It says Baguio City.
Baguio City.
Baguio City.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, you take your picture.
Yeah.
Taking. Enjoy your picture.
Thank you.
Let me fix your hair.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay. No, I can get one of these. Look at this.
Oh, yeah. Hang on. Probably the best
one
thing
minute,
I've ever seen.
Oh. This one is inverted.
Oh, and I shouldn't be wearing sunglasses either.
Yeah.
No sunglasses.
No, you can wear it, okay. But I just fixed this one.
Thank you.
Looking good. So now we're going to walk around with this on and get some pictures.
Are we going to walk around with it on?
Yeah.
There we go, look. entrance.
Here we go.
Hello.
Not going to lie, I love a gimmick, so this is hilarious. Do you know, put me in traditional attire for 50 pesos.
I might actually get, I might see if I can make this a permanent member of my wardrobe.
Yeah, let's get it in the bag. It's quite warm, but I like the colours. That's my favourite part.
I like my hat.
Yeah, the hat's good. So you've got the feathers, you've got the badge, you've got some nice jewels that she was like quite keen on the strawberries because strawberries are massive here because of the climate again. So we are going to get some strawberry flavoured food today.
I think they traditionally wore sunglasses with...
Or glasses. Anyway, let's go and check out the view because that's the main thing, not the attire, but I'm loving this.
How far do we have to walk with this one?
I don't know.
So, when Abby says it's a tourist thing and everyone's wearing them, we're at the view deck and we are the only people out of 50 wearing this. and we already stick out like sore thumbs here, being I think we're literally the only tourists. Like, well, when I say tourists, the only like Westerners that we've seen here today, aren't we?
Yeah.
There's lots of obviously like Filipino tourists. But yeah, we stick out like a sore thumb, and now we've put these hats on just to let everyone know we're here, really.
But anyway, let's check out this view. It looks pretty spectacular, doesn't it? And it's always great to be able to get a good view of what a city's really like.
First things first. The views here, as Abby would say, are absolutely stunning.
Yeah, it looks like the French Alps with all of the little huts up on a hill, which is really cool, but believe me, it's a lot warmer than the French Alps.
It reminds me of Sapa in
Vietnam. Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
But it's literally terrain like you'd never seen before.
Don't get me wrong, it's a lot cooler, but when you've got these very heavy woven garments on, it gets hot very quickly.
Yeah, but it's a good view, isn't it? Definitely.
Yeah, for ten pesos as well. Like, that's what it costs, 10 pesos.
Yeah.
It's well worth it.
Bargain. Any souvenirs, guys?
Not for me today, personally. But, good, thank you. Thanks. What way? Would you want to share one?
Fancy coffee shop there.
Smells nice. So just a quick pit stop for some coffee to get our energy up for the rest of the sightseeing day. Hey, can I please just get one iced latte, please? So far really enjoying Baguio. I'm surprised at the feel of it though. Like, I didn't think it would be as big as it is, but it's like a proper, you know, city. You've got a big mall, there's so many shops, there's like loads of traffic. I thought we were just going to like a small city in the mountain that you could kind of walk around in, but yeah, it's totally different from what I expected, but still having a good time.
So many pine trees everywhere. It's like really centered around like nature, isn't it? The city, I love that. Then there's too many parks, you're like, which one shall I go and look at? So a quick little stop off in the area is the mansion, which is the summer residence for the president. Now today it looks like you can't go in at all. I think on normal days you can go have a mooch around the museum, but we've just quickly pulled up outside to check it out. It looks, obviously, if it's the president's summer residence, it looks super grand, but wouldn't mind living in that through my summertime, that's for sure. And across the road is Wright Park, but we don't have time to visit there today. We've got too many stops on the list, but we might try that in another video. We will see. But yeah, it looks pretty cool as well. We stopped at a little lunch destination called Lemon and Olives, which is, I think, a Greek restaurant. It was in loads of articles and has loads of reviews online, so it's meant to be really popular here. And driving past it now looks to be quite full, so hopefully we're going to get some nice, tasty lunch. Nice.
Yeah.
Hi.
Afternoon.
For two,
yeah.
We're around the area.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hello. 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 Afternoon.
Bye.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Ooh. Oh, we've got a nice view.
Look at that
view. Yeah, that's a good view, isn't it?
So we've got some prime real estate here, guys. Check out this view. It's absolutely unreal. Got some Christmas songs blasting. Honestly, I am so confused as to where we are today. Like, it's confusing because it's a Greek restaurant. We're in the Philippines. We've got Christmas music playing, but it's hot. And then we're in the mountains with this view. Like, my brain is just like, where are you in the world right now? But it's stunning. One of the probably the best lunch spots we've had in a long time. So I'm really hoping the food lives up to it.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We've ordered loads of food. This is just like our starters and sides. It's not even our meal yet. But we didn't have any breakfast today, did we?
We always do this, don't we?
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yes. So we've gone for a chicken kebab and I've got another salad on the side, didn't realise that. Gazan doesn't even wait, doesn't even pause. He just eats as soon as it hits the table. Good.
I've got chicken kebab, pita bread, and we're sharing some chips. And you ordered chips, but yeah, pretty...
A feast. The whole table's full, isn't it?
Mm. Well, that was thoroughly enjoyable. I would highly recommend if you are... Where did we just go? Mines View Deck. If you're around the Mines View Deck or the mansion, or in Baguio for a fact, get yourself down here for some Greek food.
We're driving around the John Hay Park now, guys, but we have no idea what it is.
It was like, I feel like we've just entered like a resort. Like there was like a Starbucks, a BDO bank, bloody loads of restaurants, and I'm just driving.
A lot of trees over here, look.
I don't really, paintball? Understand what I'm driving to. So this place here was like a rest and rehabilitation center for American soldiers in World War II. But yeah, it's very strange, a lot bigger than I thought.
Scout Hill.
Go-kart, mini golf.
Butterfly
what should
country,
we do? Mini golf.
Area.
Mini golf.
Nah, I don't know.
Should
just drive through
go-kart
it first.
Go-kart in. Yeah, let's just have a drive around.
Okay, so we saw a sign for the Bell Amphitheatre, Secret Garden, and a few other things, which I think I read online. It's the stuff you're meant to see here. It's just slightly off the main road, which is why we didn't see it. So, yeah, we're going to check them out. We still don't quite understand if that's what you're supposed to do here, but it looks really cool. People are, like, literally parked up having their, like, dinner
yeah,
outside.
Yeah, people
the
having
cars.
Picnics.
Yeah,
and
picnics is cute, isn't it?
Yeah, it's cute.
It's so, like, centred around nature, this city. It's proper cool. It's really interesting. So here we are at the Bell Amphitheatre, which is essentially a beautiful amphitheatre which you can rent for events, etc. But it seems like a lot of people are just stopping here to take some quick photos, aren't they?
They are.
And there's some nice flowers around the edge, and it is very well kept and very beautiful, to be fair. Very nice indeed.
It says it's essentially telling you to be more positive.
You definitely need to get in there then.
I'm surprised there's not like a gust of wind keeping me out of here.
Yeah.
The alarm goes off when I get in here.
You're literally glass half full and I'm glass half.
So
no,
this
I'm
is
glass half full, you're glass
here,
half
here. Negativism is a man's greatest self-imposed affliction, his most limiting factor, and it says no more, for here is buried the world's negativism for all time. Don't believe it, but alright.
It's been so negative, come
on. And there's a cockroach on the side.
Is that actually real cockroach?
I think so.
Oh yeah.
Boss won't lettuce, a great idea. What?
We really don't have the facts for you today, guys. We're not quite sure. Hospital? We've not grasped what the tombstones are.
I think it's meant to be funny, look. It's got a monkey, it says born December 1905, died 1903. So, I think it's meant to be funny. So Abby's like, be respectful, Gaz. There's I think it's just like a funny thing.
Oh, like a quirky.
Quirky. Story. I'm so confused.
This isn't really. This. I don't know why with this. Is it us today or is it this?
No,
place?
No, this is random.
Yeah, it's random.
You can't tell me it's, this is serious.
Yeah, it's not, I don't think.
Gaz feeling at home with all the negativity. You alright down there?
Can't go any further. Just standing here.
I think the main attraction to this camp is clearly like the scenery and the trees, etc., rather than the actual things to do.
I think there's probably more things to do for kids as well, but you can see how like people could come and spend a day here, get some food,
yeah,
chill in the picnic benches.
But I also think, like, correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, by the way, but I don't know how often Filipinos see this kind of terrain, like with pine trees and obviously a cooler climate in their own country. So I can see why it's super interesting to come and holiday here and like experience this, because it is a very random place. We keep saying how random it is. It's not, it's just confusing. It's just random. I don't even know how to explain that. Maybe I'll be able to decompartmentalize that a bit more, but it's just not what you'd expect. Even the stops that we're doing feel random. We're having a great time though. It's just random.
So we spent the rest of the afternoon wandering around the secret garden before getting caught in a huge downpour, which is exactly why everyone was driving cars here and not scooters. I think we found Baguio random because it actually had quite similar activities to the UK. Epic viewpoints and spots made for tourists in nature that don't always make sense. This is confusing to us as we knew we were in the Philippines, but it just really didn't feel like it that day. Anyway, the main takeaway from Baguio is that it is a city centered around absolutely beautiful nature, and the top things to do here encourage you to be outside and experience that. A fantastic holiday destination for Filipino tourists and a very interesting travel stop if you're a foreigner. Hit subscribe if you enjoyed this video and don't forget to click the next one up on the screen now.